Team 4, we are going to demonstrate our car locator product. So let's go ahead and get started with that. First thing you need to do is turn on the PDA and run the car locator program. After you do that, you take your Etherpad tracking box and you flip the switch to turn that on. You'll know that it is on because a bright light will be shining. After you have done that, you take your PDA and you select indoor tracking mode. You set it to tracking and you select go. At which point a dialog box will pop up and you will input what parking level you are parked at. If that is not applicable, there's a button for that, and once you do that, it will start tracking. So let's go ahead and get going.
I accidentally got my shit together. Would I get a medal or a pat on the back and a little feather I could stick in my cap, a pin to my shirt, go out in the yard and poke it in the dirt, or leave it in the woods where it couldn't be found? If it fell over, would it make a sound? And if it did, would it be the sound that you like? Or should I do it over until I get it right? You say everything I know is wrong, so do me a favor and play along for a minute as the rusty gears turn. Don't be alarmed if you smell something burning upstairs. It's a little BB rolling around in a boxcar. See us together. Maybe it wouldn't be hard to explain if I only had a brain.
Okay, so now we have reached the end of the parking lot. At this point, all I need to do is click done on the PDA and it will log my information. So let's do that and then we'll check out some results. Okay, so here we are back at the parking garage. Now, we need to get back to our car, but if you don't remember what parking level you parked on, you can always ask the user interface. There's a button for that. If you do, then you just go. Let's go. So here we are again, and we're going to begin the return procedure. What you need to do is go to your PDA and select indoor tracking mode again. But this time, instead of tracking, select return. So once you do that, we hit go, and we're off. At this point, the PDA will have two compasses, and they will be pointing me into the right direction to get back to my car. So let's follow that. Alright, here we are back in our car by following the arrows on the user interface. According to the PDA, we traveled a distance of 83 meters and we were off by a distance of 6. So we didn't do too bad. This concludes our demo and we appreciate you and thank you very much.
Alright, my name's Thomas. I'm going to continue on with our demo and I'm going to be covering the outdoor tracking portion of our project. I've arrived here at my parking destination and I feel pretty confident there's going to be GPS signal here. So I'm going to go ahead and start the program and then I'm going to select outdoor tracking mode and I'm going to say tracking and I'm going to hit go. Now I'm going to be presented with a dialog box that will tell me to press done when I've reached my destination. And then now I've pressed OK, and I just need to turn on my GPS and select my GPS. Now I just gotta wait a minute for it to acquire signal. All right, we've acquired our signal. So now I'm free to go wherever I want. So here we go. One thing you'll notice that while you're tracking, you can see exactly how far you've traveled and also your direction relative to north. You can also look at the second compass and see which direction you are away from your car. In our case, it's that way, and you can see exactly how far you are away from your car. So let's go ahead and keep going. Much know where I'm at, so I'm not really interested in tracking my path anymore. I've got my waypoint stored as where I park my car, so I'm going to go ahead and press done, and then we'll be done for now. All right, well, I'm back now, and I'd like to get back to my car. So I'm going to go ahead and start the program up again, and then I'm going to select, make sure it's selected for outdoor tracking, and then I'm going to hit return, and I'm going to hit go. I'm going to follow the same steps as before, press OK on the dialog box, make sure the GPS is turned on, and select my GPS unit. Once again, it's going to have to acquire the satellite signal, so make sure you hold it up in clear view of the sky, and then once we've got that, we're ready to go. All right, well, let's go. My car and everything looks good, so I'm going to go ahead and press done, turn everything off, and we're good to go. Thank you. All right, well, now I'd like to return back to my car, but as you can see, I've come out from a different place than where I stopped tracking. With our outdoor tracking feature, that is completely acceptable. All I gotta do is turn the program back on, select outdoor tracking, select return, and then hit go. Now, once again, it's gonna pop up the dialog box, press OK, and then I just need to make sure my GPS is turned on, select my GPS device, and then it's just gonna wait a few seconds for GPS to connect, and once I've got a connection, then I'm free to go back, and it's gonna direct me right back to my car. So let's go. Now it looks like I've made it to my car. Obviously I can see it from where I'm at, so we've got a good number of precision. So now that I'm here, I'll go ahead and hit done, and then I'm ready to go.
Hello, my name is Henry Hernandez. I'm the group lead for tier number 4, and I'll be walking you through the components of our system. First of all, we have a PDA. This model here is an HP iPac H454555 Pocket PC. with a built-in Bluetooth transmitter. Next, we have a GPS unit. This particular unit is a Pharos GPS receiver, which is connected to a battery-powered Bluetooth dock, which allows it to connect wirelessly to the PDA. Next, we have the main part of our project, the user path tracking box. This box consists of a circuit board with a step counter circuit, direction finder, and wireless transmitter that sends data to the program running on the PDA. I will continue to go over the components of our system. Following is a description of our radio control failsafe system. Here's the model we made of our car that represents the user's vehicle. In the rear of the car, we can see a battery pack that powers the circuits. Underneath the hood, we can see the major components of our radio control failsafe system. This box contains the radio receiver. Here you can see it in more detail. The battery pack we use is a 12-volt lead-acid battery, which would allow us to simulate a real car more closely. This is the remote control unit that activates the RCFS system. A unit identical to this one is located inside the user path tracking box, which is activated by a relay. When the user activates the remote control, the car will begin making noise to alert the user of its location. The range of this transmitter is about 30 meters. This has concluded our presentation. We hope you have enjoyed it, and we appreciate your time. Thank you.